are old legends that talk of the place. It's a very special place. There is a crossroad here. Those who are chosen by the ancestors can communicate with death.
Hey guys, welcome to Happywax TV. So yeah, I wasn't going to watch this movie, just like I wasn't going to watch I Am Fear. But I don't know, I just watched them anyways. And much like I Am Fear, it's not a perfect movie and there is some things wrong with it. But at the end of the day, it's definitely watchable and a lot better than I thought it was going to be. The story we're talking about tonight is the movie called Eight, a South African horror story. Wow, I saw this trailer eons ago, like probably, I don't know, close to a year ago. And I didn't even do a trailer review for it just because I don't know, there was just something about it. It didn't catch my eye. So I passed on it. And then I got a copy of it just the other day. Again, I wasn't going to watch it just because of the trailer. It didn't wow me. And I've got so many other fucking movies that I've got to try and squeeze in that are coming out. And then my buddy Jay, I went to high school with him, Jay Ertman. He's huge into horror like I am. And he asked me if I'd seen this. He said it was pretty good. And I value his opinion. He's got the same kind of mindset, I think, for the most part, when it comes to horror movies. And I hadn't watched it, but he recommended it. So I'm like, fuck it, I'll give it a go. And goddamn, movie was pretty fucking good. Now, I don't know any of the backstory or the lore of South Africa. I'm not familiar with it. You know what I mean? Which may have hurt me a little bit going into this because I don't know all their mythologies and stuff like that. But, you know, they kind of keep it simple and they do a great job. Harold Holscher, who is the director and writer, does a great job of giving, some background history through flashbacks in this movie of what happened to one of our main characters. So let me just get into it here quickly. Firstly, I just gave you the director. I'll tell you, the acting in this movie is fucking top notch. It really is. Ing Beckman plays Sarah. Garth Breitenbach plays William. Now, they're a married couple, and they adopt their niece, Mary, who is played by Kita Luna, and she is fantastic in this movie. I'll tell you, kid actors, man, they're either hit or miss, and Kita Luna is fucking bang on the money, and I want to see her more in more stuff. They adopt Mary, and because of a bankruptcy, William has to move back to his recently passed father's farm. Okay, so they come back there, and Mary's parents were killed as well, so they've adopted her. Okay, so they take her with her as their daughter. And they're kind of, going through hard times, not only because of the bankruptcy, but because Sarah can't have any children. So, you know, there's always that tension between William and Sarah because of that fact, because they want kids. But Mary's there now, even though it's for a bad situation, but it's kind of helping. And then we're introduced to Lazarus, who plays, and I don't want to screw his name up, but I think it's Shimano Sebi is how you say his name. Man, I've never seen this guy before in a movie. He is fucking fantastic as Lazarus, and I want to see more of him. I knew I was going to like this movie from the opening scene because it shows him kind of like as a dark figure walking into this elderly man's room. He's got a big leather sack over his back, kind of like a nod to Takashi Mike's audition. Okay, but he puts this sack down, and he's pretty cool. He sits in this chair as this old man is kind of taking his last breaths, and he's kind of humming this. I don't know if it's like a South African kind of a beat, that makes sense. But anyways, he's all kind of shadowy. He's got this cool looking, I'm not sure if it's a Western style hat on, and he's got like the full length kind of leather jacket on. And he sits there, you know, as this man and is dying, and he finally sees him. And then he gets up and he walks over to them. And then the next scene that we see, and this is the opening scene, we see him walking out the door with this leather sack over his shoulder, and they kind of pan down to the old man, who looks like his soul is sucked out of him, okay? Or just got the life sucked out of him, which in essence is what he did, or what has happened. Because if you read the synopsis, I'll give you the quick synopsis. An old man, fated to collect souls for eternity, seeks atonement after trading his daughter's soul. So, I don't want to give too many spoilers for this. Again, it's one of these movies, the less you know going into it, the better experience it will be for you. But basically, when this couple and Mary move back to his, like the dad's or the uncle's farm, we get introduced to Lazarus again, okay? Because he kind of comes across Mary playing in the forest with these caterpillars and stuff. And he brings Mary back to, you know, the aunt and uncle there, and introduces himself and says, "I used to be one of your dad's workers, you know, and didn't realize he passed away." So again, I don't want to say too much, but I mean, we know that Lazarus has to collect souls. He's basically, what he's done is he's sold his soul to the devil. Okay. And he has to do certain things in order for stuff in his life to continue to happen. Okay. Now the tribes people who live, you know, nearby this farmhouse, They kind of introduce themselves to this family, okay? So you're kind of put in this, in the second act, you're kind of put in this turmoil of you're trying to figure out who the good and bad people are. Because Lazarus seems like an okay guy, you know what I mean? Especially when we learn his background, the opening scene aside, okay? And what he went through with his wife dying, giving birth to his daughter, and then his daughter later dying in a house fire. Okay, but, you know, again, we're thrown into this turmoil because we don't know if the tribes people are the bad people here, or if Lazarus is an actual demon, like they're calling him, okay? And it's kind of back and forth, and you really don't know. And then when the third act happens, I'm not going to say nothing, okay? So you can hate me in the comments, but I'm telling you, you know, just watch this movie as it unfolds. Now, I will say this. It's a little bit long, okay? And most of you know, as I say this 90% of the time, it's an hour and 40 minutes, okay? And there are some scenes where they really could have shaved this down. I appreciate what they were trying to do. Character building is a big thing in movies, especially if the director wants you to care about the characters, and I get it, and he did a fairly good job, but there are some scenes that are just too long. And it does kind of take you out of this movie a little bit at some points, okay? But then there's other scenes where it puts you right back in it again. So, you know, it's kind of hit and miss, but it's an hour and 40. They could have shaved easily 10, 15 minutes off this just to kind of keep the pace going. But, you know, this is a lower budget horror movie too. Not like a zero budget. I mean, it had a little bit of chunk of change. And it shows, and I mean, the cinematography in this movie and the effects that are mostly practical, but when they are used, look fantastic. And the prosthetics on, I don't want to give spoilers, but anyways, when you see certain things, you know, the prosthetics on these things look fucking killer. So, I mean, everyone did a great job on this movie. And I said this earlier, the acting in this movie is fantastic. I mean, the story itself is great. It's not like a cookie cutter kind of a supernatural, you know, type movie, which is what it is. It's a supernatural. There's not a lot of scares in this movie. They go more for the creepiness and the supernatural aspect. But I mean, they very easily could have turned it into a cookie cutter type style of movie, and they didn't. I mean, there's some twists and turns in this movie, and it keeps you guessing. And then when the third act actually unfolds in front of you, well, I don't know. I was happy with the ending, and I actually want to see more from this director, especially of this being his first feature length. He's done some short films and some TV shows, but I don't know. To give it a rating, I would probably give this movie a really strong 6.5. Again, I wasn't going to sit down and watch this, but it got recommended to me. And again, just like I Am Fear, this movie 8 was a surprise, and I was actually impressed as to how good it was. So I definitely want to see more from these guys. And I definitely want to see more acting roles from Shimano Sebi, if that's how you say his last name, because he is a killer fucking actor. And really, I mean, everybody in this movie was great, but I mean, his character was awesome as Lazarus. So anyways, guys, it's out now. If you have seen it, let me know what you thought of it. And if you haven't, go and rent it and then get back to me and let me know what you thought about this movie. And if you want to see more from this director and from these actors, I thought they were great. So anyways, the movie is called Eight, a South African Horror Story. Guys, make sure you check it out. And as always, stay scared.